Pests and diseases of crops. Our learning objectives. You should be able to describe pests at the end of the lesson. You should be able to classify pests based on parts of plant they attack. You should be able to classify pests based on the animal types. You should be able to describe the life cycle of cotton stainer. You should be able to enumerate the methods of pest control. You should be able to describe common plants and animal diseases caused by pests and their agents. What are pests? Pests are organisms that are capable of causing damage to man, livestock, and crops. How do pests cause this damage to crops? This is as a result of either when pests are feeding, or maybe they are seeking for food or water. They can be able to, through that process, they cause these damages. Plant pests are called weeds. Now we'll be looking at different ways by which pests are being classified. The first one, we are going to look at classification of pests based on the part of crop they attack. We have the first one as the stem burrowers. These are pests that they feed on the stem of plants. The example is a moth. A moth bore the stem of a plant. Especially maize is a typical example of such plants. A moth bore the stem of maize and feed on it. This will definitely weaken the stem, that even at the slightest wind that blow will always break the stem. The stem will split into pieces because of the damages that the moth has caused on it. We have the root feeders. These are plants that feed on roots of plants. Example, yam beetle. The adult yam beetle will always feed on the roots of yams. It will burrow into the roots of the underground yam and feed on the yam tubers. We have leaf feeders, those that feed on leaf of plants. For example, butterfly, grasshopper, and locust. They feed on leaves of plants. You can even see something like a snail. Yeah, a snail is another example of an animal that feed on leaves of plants. Caterpillars, these are different animals that we can see there. So they cause their own damages by feeding on leaves of plants. We have young shoot feeders. Example of such plants, we have aphid, mealybugs. They feed on the young shoots of plants. That's the pest that we call the young shoot feeders. We have the fruit and seed eaters, those that have the ability to pierce the fruit of different plants. We have piercing moths, we have the fruit flies, or we have the cotton stainer, we have certain beetles. So their own damages is always on the fruit and seed of plants. They pierce and feed on these fruit and seeds. Now let's look at classification of animal of pests based by on the type of animal they are. We have two major categories here, which are the invertebrate pests and vertebrate pests. Invertebrate pests, pests that lack backbone. These are vertebrates that destroy the invertebrate that destroy crops. Example are the nematodes. We have the nematodes there. Example of a nematode, we normally call them a general name roundworms. We have the arthropods. We have the locust, grasshopper. We have the weevil and beetles, the lepidopterans. These are examples of the invertebrate pests that affect crops. So why we have the vertebrate pests? The vertebrates, animals that has backbone, that are capable of causing damages to crops. Example are birds, mammals, like you can talk about rabbit, rodents, monkeys, even birds, they are found here. These are the animals that attack plants at the early stage. They pierce and suck either milk juice that are found in them. Example, you can see a bird will always perch on a rice and suck the milky rice juice. So these are the two classification of pests based on the animal types. We are going to be looking at the life cycle of insect pests. On life cycle of insect pests. In life cycle of insect pests, we have two major types of life cycle based on their metamorphosis. Those that have complete metamorphosis and those that have incomplete metamorphosis. But we'll be looking at a simple one, a simple life cycle of a cotton stainer. If you look at the life cycle of a cotton stainer, a cotton stainer is one of the insect pests that undergoes incomplete metamorphosis. You can see cotton stainer there, you can see grasshopper, you can see termite, you can see bugs. These are different insects that undergoes incomplete metamorphosis. Why, when you talk about complete metamorphosis, you can see something like butterflies, beetles, ticks, bees, housefly, they undergo complete metamorphosis. What is complete metamorphosis? A life cycle that happens that four stages are involved. Why incomplete metamorphosis is the type that the four stages are not involved. It's only about three stages. What are the four stages? You see the adult, you see the egg, you see the larva, and you see the pupa. Why in incomplete metamorphosis, it always happens that you see the adult, you see the egg, you see the nymph, and back to adult. So a cotton stainer undergoes incomplete metamorphosis. The cotton stainer, this is the adult stage of a cotton stainer. A cotton stainer is one of them organism that feeds on the cotton. So let's look at its life cycle. This is the adult stage of the cotton stainer. It lays its egg about 100 of it in moist soil. That's where it lays this egg. This egg will hatch and form a small nymph. This is the small nymph. This small nymph will always molt about 5 times. It will molt about five times before it will reach into this adult level. That's why we always say that you see small nymph, you see large nymph with developing wings. It molts about 5 times before it reaches to this level. Here you see that we have only 3 stages here: adult, egg, and nymph. So these are the 3 stages that the cotton stainer undergoes before it reaches to full development or full adult stage. This happened within 5 weeks. This full development period happened within 5 weeks. So the adult cotton stainer, you see it feeding at this stage, feeding on the cotton. Even tomato, orange, millet, maize, and okra, it feeds on these particular crops, causing damages on these crops. Now, the major thing that the cotton stainer does is that, just like aphids, it makes the young leaves to coil. When it coils, it will reduce the growth of the entire shoot. It resulting to a stunted growth. So the deposition of this sweet feces on the leaves will cause a coating color or stinking fungus to develop. So this particular thing is some of the damages that are caused by a cotton stainer or any of the sucking insect pest. Now, if we look at the pest of some common plants, we see different crops, different pests, and their effect as well as their control measures. We have the maize. In the maize here, we have a stem borer. When you talk about stem borer, what's an example of stem borer? That's what you should be asking now. Example of a stem borer, we have something like the moth. It's a stem borer that we weaken the stem. Stunted growth will occur, and as well as death. You can control this by using 140 cototine. Yam, we have yam beetle. It affects the yam cilia and tubers. They are attacked as well. We have cassava, mealybugs are the pests that are involved here. These plants take the plant juice and cause distortion and shoot dries up. We have the cotton stainer that feeds on cotton. It feeds on immature cotton seeds and stains the cotton yellow or brown. So we have cocoa plants. we have that the pest that feeds on it is capsid bugs. It feeds on the leaves and stems of this plant. We have rice. Remember, we have capsid bugs for cocoa. We rice here, we have drop seed flies. Remember, capsid bugs for cocoa, drop seed flies for rice. The larva of the drop seed flies attack the leaves, the terminal leaves of this plant, and turn it to yellow. Why we have cowpea, the leaf hopper affects cowpea, it feeds on leaf, causing leaf distortion and stunted growth. So these are the different control measures, the different chemicals that can be used in order to control this pest. Okay, the next one, we have control of pest. What are the different ways that we can control this pest? We have physical method, we have cultural method, we have biological method, and we have chemical method. Now, physical method, it involves the physical activities, either by collecting instead of all physical activities that are involved for you to collect this pest, either by using traps or even by using any means to destroy it, like picking them with hand, destroying them with your leg, just something like snails and caterpillars are often picked up while you see them. So this adult insect, any physical measure that is being taken, either burning, flooding them with water, or if you undergo any of these measures, these are the ones that we call the physical method of pest control. The cultural method, is being dependent on the farmer, where the farmer undergoes either crop rotation, either closed seed practice. This process we try to allow different crops with different resistance to be initiated into the farm in order to make sure that this pest will not affect the crops in the farm. We have biological method, the biological method where you use the natural enemies of these animals to destroy the pest. Such enemies, you can use predators, like using a cat to introducing a cat to come and eat up the rodents. It's a very good biological method. So if you look at the chemical method, where you use chemicals like pesticide, if you use them to kill or reduce the growth or their reproductive rate of this pest. So these are the three ways, or the four ways that we can be able to use to control pests. Diseases of crops. What are diseases of crops? Plant diseases are changes in those changes that occurs in the plant physiology. These are being caused by either biotic or abiotic agents. But we'll be looking at the biotic agents that are involved here, which are bacteria, fungi, and virus. These are the diseases that we'll be looking at. We have diseases and their symptoms here. We have black and smut. This is when here you see a small gray or brown spot on leaves. It's caused by a fungus. It's found in rice. How can you control this? You can flood the nursery bed to reduce infection, as well as using plants with resistant varieties. Plants that has resistant to this black and smut disease, that have the resistance to these fungus. So you can use them to control these diseases as one. Use of fungicide is also another way. Now, rust. Rust is another disease that affects plants. We have mildew, we have wilt, we have blight, we have gall. So rust affects maize and coffee, it's a fungal disease. The mildew affects grapes, it's a fungus disease. Wilt affects cassava, it's a bacterial disease. Rice, the blight affect rice, a bacterial disease. Cowpea, it affects is being affected by gall disease. It's a bacterial disease. So one thing that you should understand here is that almost all these diseases, you can control them by applying plant resistant method. If you apply that method, it works very well. If you can introduce plant with resistant varieties, you can be able to control that. Use of fungicide is always a good method to use to control all the fungus diseases. Why? When you come to bacteria, early planting, we control that. Destroying the infected plant is another good way that you can use to control this disease. Why? The use of these chemicals or use of physical method or cultural method, which involve crop rotation, can help to control these plants. Thank you.